Patients are there, many and increasing. So, arteriole. Any drugs, they are acting on arteriole, not on the aorta. All the this anti-hypertensive medicines, arteriole. Chemoreceptors, they are found in carotid and aortic bodies. Okay, they are stimulated by decrease in oxygen or increased carbon dioxide and pH changes. Okay, one of the example, hemorrhage. Okay, hemorrhage. What happened? There is a decrease in the blood pressure. Okay, due to loss of blood, due to decrease in the blood volume, blood pressure. Okay, when the blood is lost, when the blood pressure is lost, sometimes what happens? Hypoxia also. More RBCs are lost.
Yes.
Or oxygen carrying capacity decreases. Okay. Hypoxia. So these hypoxia stimulate chemoreceptors present in the aortic and carotid bodies.
When help sympathetic, stimulate sympathetic.
Yes, you know everything. So they stimulate sympathetic and inhibit cardiac inhibitory centers. Okay. Sympathetic. It will act by two mechanisms during this hypoxia. It will act by two mechanisms. One is sympathetic stimulate to release the aldosterone. Forget aldosterone.
No.
He forget. That's why it means how he is asking aldosterone, adrenaline.
Norepinephrine.
Yes, epinephrine, adrenaline, aldosterone. All they are there. Aldosterone is increase the sodium. Okay, and adrenal medulla. Adrenaline. Okay, both causes vasoconstriction increase the total peripheral resistance.
Okay.
And cardiac inhibitory centers.
Like that.
Yes. Decrease means increase in heart rate.
Okay. So, Dr. Vasoconstrictor and against each other as a function.
You don't learn like this. You learn like this and the blood pressure decreases due to hypoxia. This.
Well, okay.
You read like this. Not mean the opposite like this. It will be confused. Okay. You see, just concentrate on this. Okay. You are right, but you don't learn like that. When hemorrhage, hypoxia is there like this. Okay. Then remember that I shown only one phase of the blood pressure. Okay. One phase in chemoreceptor. Suppose there is a decrease in the mean arterial blood pressure. What happened in our hotel? Decrease in the mean arterial blood pressure.
Okay.
Baroreceptors?
Inhibition.
Okay. Inhibition of baroreceptors.
Yes.
And baroreceptor inhibition occurs. What happened to the vasomotor center and cardiac?
Yes.
And cardiac inhibitory center decreases. Okay. So then, total vasoconstriction increases and cardiac output increases. Increases blood pressure, bring back to normal level.
Yes.
Okay. When I will ask the question in the examination, write the baroreceptor reflex mechanism. Then you should write
opposite.
Both. When blood pressure increases, what happens? When blood pressure decreases, what happens? Okay.
When you ask me about baroreceptor release.
Suppose if I ask specifically, means increase what happened or decrease what happened, you write only one. If I ask general question, write the baroreceptor reflex mechanism.
Okay.
Then you have to write both.
Yes.
So the baroreceptor work in hypertension also.
Yes. Because they are inhibited.
Doctor, can baroreceptor detect the hypertension?
Yes.
Decrease.
Yes, when the blood pressure is less, then also they are inhibited.
Okay.
Sometimes what happened? Sometime, okay, continuously stand, gravity, okay, gravity is there. What happened? Continuously standing, the pooling of blood more to the lower limb, and there is a decrease in the venous return. Due to gravity, venous return is decreased. When venous return decreases,
heart rate
decreases. Then what happened? There is slightly decrease in the blood pressure also. I am not going to detail blood pressure. Okay. Then how the blood reached to the CNS, very important. So immediately what happened, the blood pressure decreases, baroreceptors are inhibited.
Okay.
When the baroreceptor inhibited, then sympathetic is increases, parasympathetic decreases. So suddenly increased blood pressure supplies blood to the brain. Okay. So that's why baroreceptors are very, very, very important. Okay. They are the life-saving mechanism. Okay. Clear?
Yes.
So whenever I ask, you write both mechanism. Okay. I not means again same slide. If you repeat, you will come to me, sir. This is repetition. How again we? So that's why. Actually, I want to extract from you whether you understood or not. That's why purposely I deleted that slide, opposite slide. Okay. But in the exemption, you write. If you write only one slide, I will give 50% marks.
No, we will write both.
You should write both. Well, this is about the chemoreceptor mechanism. Okay, chemoreceptor mechanism, only this one, it is not opposite. Don't write that when there is increased oxygen, decreased blood pressure, it is not like that. Only they are stimulated when hypoxia, hypercapnia, and all the cases what happens, blood pressure decreases. Okay?
Yes.
Clear?
Yes.
We'll go to the next slide. Other vasomotor reflexes, it includes number one, atrial research stretch receptor reflex. Atrial. In atria, some of the receptors they are present. They are stretch receptors. So whenever there is an increase in the venous return, more venous return is there. So stimulation of atrial stretch receptors. Okay. So this what happened when there is more venous, this is leads to reflex vasodilatation. Okay. Stimulation of atrial system leads to reflex vasodilation. You know that whenever there is a vasodilatation, blood pressure decreases. Vasoconstriction increases blood pressure. Okay. Then thermoreceptors in the skin and hypothalamus. When a person is exposed to heat, okay, more vasodilatation, blood pressure is decreases. Okay. And exposed to the cold, vasoconstriction. Then in the pulmonary receptors also there in the pulmonary blood vessels and the lung means in the walls of the lungs also there. I am not going in detail because again they will discuss the respiratory system. Okay. Just remember that lung inflation due to stimulation of that J receptors, okay, causes vasoconstriction. One reflex name is there. I don't want to go in detail of that. You just remember that. Lung inflation, vasoconstriction. Okay. If you want more detail about this, you can refer the Guyton. If any doubt is there, you can come to me and explain. Okay. Then hormones, noradrenaline vasoconstriction, adrenaline vasoconstriction, except in skeletal muscle. Okay. During the time of exercise, okay, there is a vasodilatation of the skeletal muscle. Remember. Again, I think there is a class for you, the effect, cardiovascular effect on exercise, like heart rate and other things there, they will discuss detail. Angiotensin 2, another hormone that causes vasoconstriction.
Yes.
Okay. Vasopressin, vasoconstriction. What is vasopressin?
Desmopressin.
Secreted by?
Posterior.
Now the regulation of arterial blood pressure by the regulation of blood. This is a long-term mechanism. Long-term mechanism. It will take more time to initiate the mechanism, and it will maintain for longer duration. Okay, for years, maintain for 1 year, 2 year like that. Okay, so this is mainly dependent on kidney. Okay, kidney is the main organ to regulate that.
But the first one depends on two receptors. Receptors.
A long-term regulatory mechanism, mainly renal, okay, is divided into three. The main, most important mechanism is renin-angiotensin mechanism, okay, renin-angiotensin system. Okay. Then antidiuretic hormone, ADH, for vasopressin system, and low pressure volume receptors. Okay. We'll discuss one by one. Renin-angiotensin mechanism, most important mechanism for sodium retention in order to maintain the blood volume. Okay. When they want to blood, when the kidney want to maintain the blood volume, the sodium maintenance is important because when sodium is retained, water is also retained. Okay. If both retained, water is retained, blood volume is maintained. Blood volume is maintained, then blood pressure is maintained. Okay. Now, any drop of renal blood flow, drop means It is not drop or decrease.
Yes.
Okay. Drop means decrease. Yes. Not the drop, when you will confuse with one drop of renal blood. Yeah. Any drop of renal blood flow. Okay. Or decrease in sodium. Okay. Renal blood flow or decrease in the sodium will stimulate volume receptor found in juxtaglomerular apparatus of the kidney. Okay. Kidney has one specialized part that is called as juxtaglomerular apparatus. Okay. Juxtaglomerular apparatus. So they secrete very, very important hormone called as renin. Okay. R-E-N-I-N. Okay. R-E-N-I-N is renin is different. That is the enzyme present in the gastric juice. Okay. Don't confuse that. Renin. Single N, N, I, N. Double N means renin. If you write in the exam, double N, then I will means I'll cut the marks because you are telling the renin of the stomach. GIT, single N. Renin. So, which will act on the angiotensin system leading to production of aldosterone. Okay? This is the brief introduction, then I will explain. I'll explain. Next slide. Okay. Whenever there is a decrease in the blood flow or sodium, okay, stimulate the secretion of renin. Yes. Renin act on the angiotensin system, leading to production of aldosterone.
And reabsorption of sodium.
Yes. Decrease in the blood flow or sodium, stimulate juxtaglomerular apparatus of the kidney. So consider that there is a volume receptor present in the juxtaglomerular apparatus. Okay. Secret renin. Renin act on angiotensinogen. Okay. Angiotensinogen, it is a protein in nature and secreted by the liver. Okay. So it acts on, renin acts on angiotensinogen and convert angiotensinogen to angiotensin 1.
Okay.
Then angiotensin 1 acted upon by the converting enzymes.
Yes.
Angiotensin converting enzyme, also right, called as ACE, angiotensin converting enzyme. So, again, they will discuss detail in ACE inhibitors in the pharmacology. Angiotensin converting enzyme. Okay.
Okay.
They are secreted by the lungs.
Yes.
Okay. Lungs, they are present in the lung. They convert angiotensin 1 to 2. Okay. And 2 is again convert this converting enzyme again convert 2 to 3 also, but this is more powerful and remain for longer duration. This is also powerful but for short duration. So we are interested in angiotensin 2.
I have two functions.
Yes.
So stimulation 3 is aldosterone and have vasoconstriction.
Yes,
function.
Finish. I'll go take that in next.
Doctor, what about increased potassium? Does it activate renin angiotensin system?
No, angiotensin is acted, but mainly it is sensitive to decrease in the sodium. Mainly. Lung is the source of converting enzyme. Lung release. Okay, they will come into the blood vessels.
Some of them say this is to depend on the extracellular volume.
Yes, so blood volume and extracellular volume is same.
So even it depends on the potassium.
When that decrease in the extracellular volume, then decrease in the sodium.
Yes.
Okay. So this angiotensin. Okay. This angiotensin 2.
So measure.
Two functions. One is the powerful vasoconstrictor, directly act on the smooth muscles, blood vessels, vasoconstriction, and stimulate the adrenal cortex to secrete aldosterone. Okay, aldosterone. Aldosterone, what is the function of aldosterone?
For sodium
and water retention.
Yes.
In the sodium and water retention,
excretion,
and there's a vasoconstriction. Yes. Increase in the blood volume, hypervolemia. Okay. And the blood volume come back to normal.
Increase pressure.
And more vasoconstriction that leads to increased blood pressure brings back to normal. Okay. So aldosterone is the main regulator of sodium retention.
And increase the blood pressure, it is inhibited.
Yes, inclisiran inhibited.
So, doctor, increased sodium is long acting for hypertension.
Yes. When the hypertension is maintained. Okay. When the increased sodium, inhibition. It's clear?
Yes.
Any angiotensin mechanism. Then antidiuretic hormone mechanism, ADH or vasopressin. Okay. Antidiuretic hormone. Secreted by the posterior pituitary. Okay. So whenever there is hypovolemia or dehydration, okay, hypovolemia, decrease in the blood volume or dehydration, the loss of water due to vomiting or diarrhea, okay, will stimulate the osmoreceptors in the hypothalamus, okay, osmoreceptors, the regulation of water, the receptor present in the hypothalamus, okay, which will lead to release of ADH, okay, ADH. Two things happen when the hypothalamus osmoreceptors are stimulated. The releases ADH from the posterior pituitary. Secondly, they cause us thirst.
There is, yes.
You feel the thirst.
Right.
Okay. So you drink more water. Drink more water. So that's due to both. One, you drink more water. One is ADH. What is the function of ADH?
Retention.
Yes. Increase reabsorption of water. Instead of telling function, if you are telling the function means increase more reabsorption of water in the renal tubules. Okay, renal tubules. More reabsorption water. So more water is retained. Okay? More water is retained and volume, blood volume is increases. It will cause water reabsorption in the kidney tubules. Then lastly, the low pressure volume receptor, atrial natriuretic peptide receptor, this hormone is there, secreted from the wall of right atrium to regulate sodium excretion. So what is the function of ANP? How?
Sodium.
How sodium?
Decrease.
Yes. This is important. Yes. ANP is the opposite to the aldosterone.
Yes, decrease.
It causes, I mean, suppose there is more blood volume is there, more blood volume is there, more sodium is there, then this release, this hormone release, and it causes more excretion of sodium and bring back to volume normal. Decreases the blood volume and bring back to normal. This is the opposite to the aldosterone. Opposite to the aldosterone. Okay? Clear?
Doctor, atrial or arterial?
Atrial.
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 Okay.
Atrial. It's clear?
Clear.
So again, means increase in the blood pressure called as hypertension, decrease in hypotension. And again, we have discussed detail by the pathology.
Thank you.
So this finish.
Doctor, these two mechanisms, are they stuck together?
Which one?
Fast and low.
No. Finish. Immediate fast.